I'll make a video of my Thai curry recipe. Yesterday I went to the market, and every time I go to the market, if I spot these, I generally pick them up because I love making my own Thai curry paste. I don't like to pick up off the shelf because I don't like the aroma and the flavor. The ones which you make at home, I feel it's much more rich in flavor. So it's generally like this. I have chopped it. This is what I'm going to use, and these don't throw away. You can use it in your chai, or you can put it in your boiling rice. When you boil the rice, you can put this. It gives a very nice lemongrassy flavor. So come, today I'm going to share my Thai curry recipe with you, and do make it, and if you like it, then do share it with me. So you keep peeling it off, and you'll find the tender portion. This is the tender portion. This is what goes in the grinding masala. So the masala for your Thai curry, which goes into the grinding, is some green chilies, ginger, garlic, lemongrass, green onions, fresh basil, and fresh coriander. So you can add your green chilies as per your taste. I haven't added much because my child is going to be eating this, so he doesn't like it too spicy. So all this is going to be grinded now, and this is what your Thai curry masala is all about. Here goes my basil. Fresh basil ki khushbu hi kuch aur hoti hai. So this is the leftover lemongrass stick. I have just put it in water so that I can use this water, and it will give a beautiful aroma. So don't throw these away. You can't grind them because they're too hard, but then you can use the sticks to boil and add some extra flavor and zing to it. So this is my green Thai curry paste, which I make it at home, and it smells divine. I've put some olive oil for the vegetable to give it a stir fry. So I'm adding the onion. Giving it a quick stir. Wow, so beautiful now. This is that flavored water. Now I'm going to transfer this so that the vegetables are crunchy. This is the magical masala. You stir it a bit and then put a lid and keep it for a while. So while my green curry is getting cooked, I thought I need to add some soya chunks because I'm a vegetarian. I can't add chicken or fish, and I'm running short of paneer. So let's add some soya chunks and see how it turns out to be. It turns aromatic, nice and green. Ah, oh, it smells divine. I love Thai food. I think another 1 minute, and then I can add my veggies. Now curry is ready to be mixed with the vegetables. Give it like a quick stir. And I had forgotten, I put a little bit of sugar so that it gives a little sweet taste. Not much, a little bit. I'm gonna put my coconut milk. Pura dal do. The coconut cream and the gravy and the veggies have all put together. Yes, I'm gonna add a little bit of sugar in this and put a lid for some time, not much. I am adding the soya chunks.
I like these ones.
That's why I'm putting them.
Put a lot of them. I love them. Put the whole thing.
And now a little bit of flavored water, lemongrass water. Put a lid. And forget about it. Voila! My Thai curry, green Thai curry with lots of vegetables and my steamed rice with extra lemon grass in it is all set to go in our tummy. Let's see what the birds say about it.
You got it easily.
You finished the food.
A medium star. Wow. You got it easily.
I will. You grow up a bit first.